Happy Rocky, bro. Happy Rocky. Where's my gift?
So guys, today we thought that I'll share a couple of annoying things about Aman that I totally do not like. And he has none to share about me.
I have 10.
So we'll see.
I have 10.
So I think we want to start first.
How you start?
I think the first most annoying thing about him is that he wakes up really late. So I, when I'm in the house, like, I just keep waiting and then I'm like, okay, let's maybe do a meal together. And I'm scared to knock at his door because he can just complete. Some days he'll be very nice, yes, baby. And some days he'll really be very annoyed. So he wakes up
knocking. He really worries about what you eat.
It's good to worry about yourself, but it gets super irritating.
When she tries to force her dietary habits on you.
Second most annoying thing about Aman is that I can't make impromptu plans with him. Like, he has to be told. If I say, chalo, suddenly let's do this. Like, abhi, no way, you know. So I hate it that I can't make impromptu plans.
So the second most annoying thing about you is that
he has to think an annoying thing.
That you think you're always right. And your right is not right for me.
And you think you know everything. That's really annoying about him.
And the third most annoying thing about him is that he has no in-between, you know. If he's on a cheat meal, he will eat as much that his stomach will go for a toss. But I won't eat to a level where I'll be like, oh boy, I'm not going to eat the next day. He has things like that. He won't eat breakfast and then lunch and go on a long intermittent if he's cheated. And I say, have a balance of life to this and that.
You are. She really wants me around when she's in the house. Like, she cannot sit alone for 10-15 minutes.
I give her the bag. And she just wants me to what she wants. But a part of every plan of ours. I don't wake up in the afternoon. That's COVID time, guys. What should I do?
She gets up at 5:30 in the morning and does what? It's COVID time. She sits all by herself. That's about it.
Self-improvisation. I self-reflect.
Uh-huh. What are you reflecting?
Myself.
Okay.
Into the world.
So yeah. So she wants me to be part of her every plan. Whether it is eating, whether it's sleeping, whether it's watching a show, whether it's I don't know. It's every board games.
And I know the next thing that I want to say is that he's very short-tempered.
I'm not short-tempered.
Of course you're short-tempered.
You're short-tempered.
I'm not short-tempered.
I'm not short-tempered. You're short-tempered.
Look at your face right now. You're not short-tempered.
I'm not short-tempered.
Of course you're short-tempered.
I'm not short-tempered. You are short-tempered.
We get into fights sometimes. Even
why are you raising your voice?
We're all grown up. We get into like pillow fights like this. And like we hit each other sometimes, and it's nasty.
It's tomorrow.
No, it's today.
Then, okay.
Okay, see, agree. So cute. So happy Rakhi, guys, and keep the sibling bond alive always. You know, there could be fights, there could be arguments because no two people are similar ever. And but what really matters is the bond that you share. And as much as this guy is a cartoon, I really do.
Okay. I love her. See, she can't live without her.
Yeah.
Because I'm the only thing she has in her life. What's up? What's happening? Sare boys ko happy Rakhi bol diya.
No, guys, it's not happy Rakhi for all the guys. It's just happy Rakhi to all the brother sisters there from this brother sister. But it's not for the guys.
It's not for the guys.
Just clarify.
And not for the girls.